Hi, this is Rachel from the CW18 Crew. I'm sitting here with Jana, and she just got back from Las Vegas. She went to the iHeart Radio Music Festival. How many artists were there? Do you know?
It was over 20.
20?
It was rapid fire, though. It was like they had everybody on a rotating stage.
Really?
So there was like maybe 2 minutes in between acts. Mm-hmm. So like one act would end, and you think you could go get a drink or go to the bathroom, and the next one would start right away, and you'd have to sit back down.
Oh. Did you have a favorite artist who performed that you really liked?
No Doubt was amazing to start the show.
No Doubt. Yeah.
You know, Gwen Stefani, coolest chick ever.
Right.
And then Pink started the second night, and she's flying through the air on all these harnesses and hitting every note, singing live. Amazing
concept.
Oh my
gosh. I heard you saw Prince.
Prince walks out on
stage. You crossed that off your bucket list, right?
I did. Oh. Prince, we had heard he was in the building. Mm-hmm. And I was like, there's no way, really? And then Mary J. Blige was on stage, and she's like, I want to bring a friend of mine out. Mm-hmm. And it was Prince. And like literally, the entire place just kind of gasped for a second.
Oh gosh.
Like, is that really the Purple One? And he just, that sweet little soft voice of his, and he spoke into the microphone, and they said, let's do a song. And they do Sinead O'Connor's Nothing Compares to You, which Prince wrote and produced, and you forget for a second, to actually get him to see him perform that song live with Mary J. Blige. Really was a moment. Like,
wow.
We just had to take it in.
That's like, incredible. Cool.
Like, not a lot of people got to see that. But you will.
Yes. Yes.
I'm sure it's going to be in the show.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah, it was amazing. And then Pink came out on stage with No Doubt. Talk about double cool chick.
Wow.
They did Just a Girl together.
Okay. Cool.
That was unbelievable.
I love Pink.
Linkin Park was phenomenal. Green Day had a meltdown.
Oh, yeah. What happened?
Who doesn't love a good Green Day meltdown?
Yeah, what happened with Green Day? Tell me about that.
You know, it lasted less than 30 seconds. I think when it happened, you thought it was just, you know, punk rock, being punk
part
rock.
Part of the show, right?
It wasn't until the next morning we woke up.
Oh, really? And not
until
the next...
You see, it's all over every website out there. So it was kind of like, oh, okay.
So not until the next morning did you not know. Until,
It was just Billy Joe being
Billy Joe.
Joe,
right, of
Green
course. And smashing the guitar, just getting into it.
And then Usher was incredible with Wayne.
And Taylor
Miranda
Swift.
Lambert,
Taylor Swift. Brad Paisley.
I know. See, and it's funny because my husband, not a Taylor Swift fan.
Not a country fan, right?
And after her performance, he was like, she was incredible.
She is. She really is.
So it's the cool thing about the music festival. It's actually turning people on that maybe are Green Day, Linkin Park fans into Taylor Swift, Jason Aldean fans,
right?
Perhaps.
Mm-hmm.
Or, you know, my husband really wasn't a big follower of Pink, and now he's like I want to hang with
Pink
that girl.
Is awesome. My dad loves Pink.
I love your dad.
He dances around the kitchen to Pink while he mops the floor. Yes.
Please.
Yes,
send
Dad.
This
yes.
It was incredible. You know, it was a long distance, and you're really thinking like, gosh, you know, 36 hours and, you know, 9 hours of travel, and then you're like, oh my gosh, this is music history.
Okay.
And it's something that we were so proud to be a part of, and just to be in the audience and experience all of that star power and everybody coming together for just two nights of music history was really high on my list of the coolest things I've ever done.
That's really cool. Hopefully next year too, it's gonna happen again, right?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, great.
Absolutely, I've already booked my rooms, I'm ready.
All right.